Here is a bulletin from CBS News. In Dallas, Texas, three shots were fired at President Kennedy's motorcade in downtown Dallas. The first reports say that President Kennedy has been seriously wounded by this shooting. United Press says that the wounds for President Kennedy perhaps could be fatal. This is Walter Cronkite in our newsroom. And there has been an attempt, as perhaps you know now, on the life of President Kennedy.
Several of these men arrested have been connected by our office with a central intelligence agency of the United States government.
Did he ask you if you knew any of the people involved?
Well, I don't know what he's up to. He's picking me like chicken, shucking me like corn, stewing me like an oyster. I mean, he ain't putting nothing down but air.
I am trying to tell you that there is no question as a result of our investigation that an element of the central intelligence agency of our country killed John Kennedy, and that the present administration is concealing the facts. There is no question about it at all.
I have a special message for you from the President of the United States.
Renewed hostile actions against United States ships on the high seas in the Gulf of Tonkin have today required me to order the military forces of the United States to take action in reply.
The following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
Dr. Martin Luther King, the apostle of nonviolence in the civil rights movement, has been shot to death in Memphis, Tennessee.
The USS Liberty was attacked by three Mirage 3 fighter bombers.
Israel claims the attack was accidental, but some former U.S. naval officers say it was on purpose, and they describe the day's action as part of a continuing cover-up.
They've now said that there were 11 hostages. Two were killed in their rooms yesterday morning. Nine were killed at the airport tonight. They're all gone.
A bomb exploded early this morning in the Pentagon, and left-wing terrorists telephoned newspapers to say they were responsible.
People calling themselves members of the Weather Underground last night planted bombs in federal office buildings in Washington and Oakland, California.
Here he goes, and he will go. Darrin, he is hurt. Oh, my God.
What a jump! Evel's riding the amazing star cycle.
Evel Knievel, sold separately or with the Evel Knievel Stunt Cycle from Ideal.
Are you sure it's the measles?
Well, he certainly got all the symptoms. A slight temperature, a lot of dots, and a great big smile.
A great big smile?
No school for a few days.
Boy, this is the life, isn't it?
Yeah. If you have to get sick, sure can't beat the measles.
That's right.
Swine flu. Man, I'm too fast for them to catch me.
You'll want to be protected. Get a shot of protection. The swine flu shot.
The vaccines are safe, easy to take, and they can protect you against flu.
Washington decided that every man, woman, and child in the nation should get a shot to prevent a nationwide outbreak, a pandemic.
This virus was the cause of a pandemic in 1918 and 1919 that resulted in over 500,000 deaths in the United States.
Well, 46 million of us obediently took the shot. And now 4,000 Americans are claiming damages from Uncle Sam amounting to $3.5 billion because of what happened when they took that shot. By far the greatest number of the claims, two-thirds of them, are for neurological damage or even death.